A little disco. Yeah, Dawn's on.
Good morning, gang.
Can't believe you didn't get that Doobie Brothers song.
Oh, come on now. Come on. Hey, listen, everyone's allowed to miss one. Besides, you never miss. How the faculty people think that they've got a chance to beat me at this game.
Well, you're right.
Okay.
And you got to throw one now and then.
Let's Groove by Earth, Wind, and Fire. Make it happen. That's the song right there. It's 10 till 6 now on a good day. If you got to be to work at 7 o'clock, you got 10 minutes to get there.
God, I love doing the DJ stuff.
I love doing the DJ stuff.
See, that's what gives you such a huge advantage, though, is that you were a DJ back in the day.
DJ?
You
know. Now, are we talking Charlie Sheen here? I love talking
what
all
are we
things
talking
Charlie
here?
Sheen.
Yes, we are
I think
talking,
we're about Charlie
yeah.
Sheen
we're
in Detroit,
Sheen.
I think, right?
It was bad Detroit. They booed him off stage on his first road show in Detroit, but with a few tweaks and changes, Charlie Sheen's violent torpedo of truth tour now appears to be winning over the audiences. Sheen performed for a boisterous bunch, apparently, in Cleveland last night. TMZ reporting that Sheen once again performed with the help of a moderator who asked questions and took suggestions from audience members. Sheen even got a standing ovation at the end of the night.
Well, it's Cleveland.
Side note, though, the venue hosting Sheen did not serve any drinks out of glass. Owners were feared a repeat of the Detroit show that the audience would throw bottles on stage. Wow.
And you got to remember as well that because it's Charlie Sheen, and you know that the movie Major League was based in Cleveland, and his character, the Wild Thing, was for the Indians. So I got to think that there's nothing but love out in Cleveland for him because in Cleveland, just like in every other stop, they don't like Detroit in Cleveland. They don't like Chicago in Cleveland. Yeah. So he can go to both those cities and say, hey, both those cities sucks. Look, hey, Cleveland Indians, I'm your man. But I think it's very telling that they didn't allow people to have glass. Hello, Raiders fans. How you doing? Right. Sound familiar? Also that he's got a moderator up there with him.
Right, right.
Now, is that like James Lipton or someone sitting up there inside the Charlie Sheen mind with a big pile of cards and asking him set of questions? I don't even know. I still maintain
game. Moderator, like it's a panel discussion.
He will not make it all the way to San Francisco. I don't think the show's going to last
that long. You're pretty good about these things.
And the other thing that I found out is that all of the tickets that were bought, a large majority of them were bought by ticket brokers like StubHub, hoping to resell them. And now, at least for the show in Cleveland, I read yesterday online that at least half of the tickets the scalpers lost money on. And so now they're looking at, we've bought all of these tickets down the road. What happens if this thing doesn't really happen? What if happens if it doesn't roll? So remember, you heard it here first.
Okay. Now, phrases like winning.
And I'm ready to fall at any moment.
No, wait.
I feel the need. I feel the need for Chris the Alley.
Before you do,
I'm bracing.
I want you to, you know, we use phrases like winning and tiger blood for a while. We need to get them out of your system while you can, because Charlie Sheen is seeking copyright protection for his famous catchphrases.
Come on, Charlie.
This just in, a company with ties to the actor is applying to trademark 22 of his famous phrases, including winning, Vatican assassin, and tiger blood. So you wouldn't be able to say them without paying him for those. The company also wants to trademark his nickname for his girlfriends, which are Sheen's goddesses. So you may not call yourself Sheen's goddesses if that trademark goes
through. Now, you said in conversation all the time, too. That'd be really
difficult. You do,
don't you? Yeah, Sheen's goddesses.
Like, don't you wish you were one of Sheen's goddesses?
Kirstie Alley.
Don't you wish you were like Kirstie Alley.
I'm on the floor. You snuck it in.
I'm here all week.
Thank God for that.
Chips in the jar.
Speaking of Kirstie Alley, look who's in the doorway.
Oh, there she is.
If you want to send Dawn an email, Dawn's mailbag is ready for you. It's to be filled up. GoodDaySacramento.com at the top of our homepage there. Click on Dawn G. She looks like she's holding a beer. And she's in there with...
Of course.
Who's the other person? Can anybody tell me?
That's the guy that she dances with. Oh, watch this real fast. Maxim. Go back to the shot of us, because I'm going to do another impression for you. Like this, watch. I'm Sam Shane.
Oh, no.
Good evening. How are you, Palace?
Hey.
Hi there. Good morning. This is Sam Shane and the news.
Oh, goodness gracious. Look at that. There's information going right over my face. Right through his ears. Right through my mouth, Stockton. Wow.
Sunny Modesto.
Eat Modesto. Come on, chew on the sun. Chew on the sun.
God, I'm an idiot. I'll do anything on television, won't I? I really will. I'll just stay here for the rest of the show.
Really will.
How you guys doing?
Good. Yesterday, we were talking about dream jobs yesterday. Then you can sit back up in the chair.
I am sitting up.
Oh, no, okay. He's good.
You ever seen the movie Clifford with Martin Short? Rent it on Netflix.
Oh, look at that. Love Martin
Short. Now, Reno in my mouth. Hi there. Tahoe in my mouth. Air quality, obviously not good in my mouth.
Belly.
Ford. That's a tasty
yummy.
Ford.
Okay.
Hi there. 1 minute left.
We have a minute to fill. Really? We're
going
to do
this for
a minute?
No.
He didn't necessarily
say
that.
Even I think we got to move on. Even I think we got to move on.
We're talking about dream jobs. What was your dream summer job? Because kids are starting to look for summer jobs now, and job searches are spiking on Yahoo. Somebody wrote in and said they were he was the pool boy at the Playboy Mansion. That was his summer job.
Wow.
Somebody's got him beat.
But there was some algae there.
No, no. How about this one? Eldon Isaac says, "Well, I was the photographer's assistant at the Playboy Mansion."
I'll see your Playboy story and raise you another Playboy story.
Apparently you will.
That beats the heck out of Space Camp.
You know, it really does. Or Taco Bell. That was my summer job. Yeah. Your lovely wife sent us a picture this morning.
My wife?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
She's watching change now.
Right. She's all the way on the East Coast. What's she doing sending
pictures?
She's
all the way back on the East Coast. Let me show you. I know, and I forgot about that. She sent a beautiful sunrise picture this morning. Look at that.
You got to get your hands greasy.
That's from your lovely wife.
Oh, you know what? That's in Hawaii. That is from Ocean City, Maryland.
The other end of Highway 50.
3,083 miles away. You are correct, Marianne.
Yeah, how about
that? That's a beautiful shot.
That's a lovely shot.
Good morning, baby. I love you, and I miss you, and come back home. I'm running out of clothes, and obviously I'm also running out of ideas for the show.
He's running out of food.
Come back. But again, NBA in my mouth.
This space is available, though, if you want to rent it right here.
All right, coming up in the 7 o'clock hour, up next, we are talking live with Barbara Eden. So we want to see your genie blink. Take a picture of you doing the blink. Email it to us, go@kmaxtv.com. We'll show them live on the air.
All right.
Stand by for that. All right.
New at 7, Marcus Allen learns how to do makeup like Lady Gaga would wear.
And as we said, we're live with one of Hollywood's most beloved icons. Barbara Eden talks about her new memoir, Genie Out of the Bottle. Next.
Wait till you have that growth spurt. Oh, it could happen anytime.
That's attractive. Oh, hi. Hey, how are you anyway? Hi there. And good morning, all that stuff. Hi there. Come on. Oh, I'm still on TV. Hi there. Nope.